GSP is arguably the greatest mixed martial artist of all time. In this video, I'll be describing the key themes from GSP's autobiography, The Way of the Fight. Fear was a prevalent theme throughout the book. GSP continuously referred to fears he faced throughout his life and fighting career, from being bullied at a young age to the fear of losing and being humiliated in front of millions of people. GSP writes, "I wasn't always the strong one. Fear made me. I don't like fear, but I do love it, and there's a major difference there. Because of what my fear makes me do. Because of how my fear has made me who I am. In between my Hughes fights, my fear delivered one of the great lessons of my life, that someone without fear can't push himself. He can't get better. He can't transform negatives into positives. Some people are totally incapable of seeing fear as an opportunity to get better at something. Some people wallow in their fears and try to suck their friends into the pit with them. I don't really like hanging out with these people. I want my friends to help me look at possibility. This doesn't mean my friends should bullshit me about how great everything is, but the key is looking at problems as opportunities to find new solutions." GSP's willingness to look for friends and coaches that would help him improve and cultivate self-belief was another prevalent theme in the autobiography. In fact, GSP credits a large part of his success and confidence to his coaches. Some of GSP's coaches were his father, Christoph Mido, John Donaher, Faraz Zahabi, Freddie Roach, and Gavin McMillan. GSP writes, "Something important for you to know is that I hire to my weaknesses. I've always looked to learn from experts that know more than I do." For example, when GSP was 16 years old, he tracked down Christoph Mido to personally ask him to be his coach. When GSP was 17, he would travel 9 hours from Montreal to New York to study Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. GSP made these trips on his personal expense. He would use the money he earned working as a garbage man to pay for expenses. "I went to New York for a reason," GSP writes. "I was lucky to understand early on that there were always more coaches in the world that I could learn from." The third key theme in the book was GSP's dedication to his vision and daily routines, which is what GSP says is what he likes the best about himself. GSP says, "I've never been the fastest, strongest, biggest, quickest, or most powerful. Do you want to know what I like the best about myself? The truth is, I've become great at maybe only one thing. Dedication. It gets me to the gym when I don't feel like going and helps build good habits. My life isn't very exciting. Most of the time I get up and I go to the gym to work out. Then I eat, then I work out again, get a therapeutic massage so I can work out again later, and then I eat more. Then I go back to sleep. That's it for most days, and I love it. In fact, I wouldn't know what to do other than follow this routine. When I wake up, the first thoughts inside my head are that day's training. Where I must go, what time I must be there, with whom I'll be training, my goals for the day. Life is a program now, a schedule, a balancing act etched into my brain. The written schedule I used to refer to is redundant now. I don't even know where it is." The fourth theme in the book was GSP's openness to learning. GSP says that he tries to put himself in as many learning situations as possible. When GSP learns something new that he likes, GSP looks for ways to add it to his existing mental representations and frameworks. GSP describes his frameworks as workshops. He writes, "The two basic workshops I have are A, the physical workshop, and B, the mental workshop. So, for example, doing gymnastics goes in the physical workshop, while philosophical discussions about visualization, for example, go into the mental workshop. The third workshop is the fusion workshop, where I put all that knowledge together in my own particular way. It's where shootbox comes from. It's what defines me best, to some." Shootbox is George's own term. It refers to the act of integrating striking skills with takedown skills. According to his coach, John Donaher, shootbox has been perhaps the single most important ingredient in the development of George's success as a mixed martial artist. It is important to note that George's innovative shootboxing skills emerge from active and continuous efforts to learn more and combine knowledge in his own particular way. When GSP became the world champion, he continued to change and innovate. GSP writes, "My goal is to be the most efficient, quickest thinking fighter. I aim to be flexible, open-minded, and ready for any situation. Very often, we see leaders lose sight of how they got to where they are, by being and thinking differently from the competition. They make it to first place, and then the thinking changes from seeking innovation to seeking the status quo. They think, I made it to first place, so now I must not change a thing. But change is what got them to the top in the first place. This is because they're focused on the positive result rather than on the process of success. You can't go in with the same approach over and over because it worked last time. Nowadays, every camp has access to video footage and has roughly the same technical tools as the opponent. The difference in success comes in carefully planned innovation. You must change things up, not just keep them fresh, but progress. Your strategy might come as a surprise to the opponent, critics, or fans, but in reality, it has been well-researched, learned, and trained. The last theme I will talk about is GSP's training methods and regimen. Once GSP made the commitment to becoming the best version of himself, his training regimen became a 24/7 endeavor. According to the book, GSP would train for roughly 5 to 8 hours a day. GSP writes, "We will spend hours repeating a single technique, over and over again, until I get it right. We will repeat the move, we will sit and discuss it, then start over again. We will block out all other things. We will restart until the world dissolves completely, until nothing else matters or even exists. We will repeat it until it is mastered, no matter when that will be. One certainty though, it will be." When GSP was not training, he would often be visualizing different skills. "I reflect on my movements, I replay them in my mind, I think about them, situations and scenarios. I'm thinking about this stuff all the time. In fact, every day I get lost in thought to the point that people talk to me and I'm not there. They have to snap me back into the present." For strength and conditioning, GSP did gymnastics, yoga, and specific feet training. GSP's reasoning is the following. "I believe gymnasts are the best athletes in the world. I have been training at it for years now, but I still can't do a fraction of what the good ones are able to do. The way they move and their ability to generate power from all kinds of different positions is simply amazing. Gymnasts can produce power from the most awkward positions. That's important in mixed martial arts too, because no opponent is going to move you to a more comfortable position. The truth is that you don't need a big frame or a large physique to generate force or be skillful. It's actually the opposite. What you need is to refine your motor skills. It's really not about how much weight you can lift over your head. If your prime movers can generate 500 pounds of pressure, but your stabilizers can only support 100 pounds of pressure, you're in trouble. In a worst case scenario, you may only move 100 pounds. This is not good at all, because there are rarely any good case scenarios in the heat of intense top level competition. One of the things I've been doing in training is kick and punch into the high pads while standing on a balancing board. The key is to maintain balance while generating power. True power is generating force from all positions in all situations. GSP also focuses on training his feet. He says, "If you're well balanced on the balls of your feet, you don't have to waste time shifting your weight. You go, you save time. A fraction of a second means a lifetime. A lot of other fighters stand up straight, especially the Muay Thai fighters. Recognizing this has been very important to me. It has given me an edge. In my stance, my heel almost never touches the ground, except for when I'm resting. For me, this brings my weight onto the balls of my feet, and that's where I have an advantage over most of my opponents. I'm always ready to explode or change direction." That is all for this video. Thank you for watching.